Delegates attend conferences to gain access to recent developments in their professional fields, learning about the experience of others involved in similar activities. In anticipation of these benefits, they often travel far and the cost can be quite high. Consequently, not everyone who would like to can attend every conference they consider important. Conferences, while delivering a well-structured program, also pay special attention to create a relaxed social environment to foster networking among delegates. Organizers want to create a forum of professional development by providing access to information. This is realized through three components. The least formal is the direct exchange of ideas and work experiences among peers. Technical sessions consist of prepared presentations. These are the most structured method for presenting information, research results, surveys, or statistics. And panel discussions are the least structured sessions. While the moderator selects the topics and manages the flow of questions and responses, the nature of those questions and the replies are spontaneous. These sessions are just as valuable for professional development as formal presentations. While making information available to delegates is the primary objective of all conferences, retention and prolonged access to that information is just as important. In the past, conferences distributed printed or CD-based proceedings. They required publication-ready manuscripts. Authors no longer can or are willing to do that. Today's reality is that presenters seldom have more than a set of slides. Having nothing to put into proceedings, practically no event publishes them anymore. Consequently, for registered delegates, there is nothing tangible to take home other than maybe some side notes in the program or a few memorized statements or statistics. After all the advancements of digital technology, there must be, and there is, a way to fill that void left behind by the disappearance of proceedings. We need to think outside that box. How will it look? Formal presentation comprised of the verbal delivery, supported by slides and or videos. This may also include occasional interaction with the audience. All can be recorded and made available 24/7. Plenary sessions are less scripted. They are dialogues, sharing knowledge and experiences between the expert panel and the audience. All can be recorded and made available 24/7. Poster sessions are great opportunities for researchers or students to report on ongoing projects. A dialogue with visitors reveals specific details of their work. All can be recorded and made available 24/7. Most conferences include a trade show, often referred to as InfoMart, and this is an opportunity for vendors and sponsors to demonstrate their contribution to the industry sector of what the conference is catering to. All can be recorded and made available 24/7. How is it done? Recording means simply tapping into the already existing audio-visual setup. Only a few additional steps are required. 1. Install a recording software on the slide host computer. 2. Connect that computer to the PA system to get the audio. And 3. Feed the video feed signal. And voila, ready to go. The presenter and his or her image and voice are merged with the digitally captured slides in sync. It can't get any simpler. How is it delivered? The separately recorded presentations are combined into a format that is essentially a multimedia version of traditional printed proceedings. The table of contents is replaced with a title list and page numbers with buttons. Those buttons bring the selected presentation into the projection screen. Multimedia players provide several viewing controls. In this application, the pause is the most frequently used one because slides often contain so much information that need time to fully analyze and take notes. A display of sponsor credits and a link to access the feedback form completes the event homepage that may as well be called Proceedings in Soft Cover. Who benefits? 1. Delegates who could not attend certain sessions or just need to review what they may have missed. 2. Those association members who were not able to register to the event. And 3. The event organizer by fulfilling its mandate to support professional development. All of this fits most conference budgets. Printed proceedings did cost about $17 per delegate. In contrast, digital recording and the electronic distribution of presentations costs are in the $2 to $3 per delegate range. Important to note that it may even become a revenue source when made available for a fee to those who did not register. How Viewers Use the Technology. Mary Duggan, Manager, Canadian Society for Exercising Physiology.
Synchronized video recording of symposia at our conference provides the opportunity for members who could not attend to view the video online at their own convenience. Presenters who are professors teaching the material may use these communication tools to enhance and complement their in-class offering on a topic. It is a cost-effective way to bring information to those who cannot attend a live event.
Amel Ratnayak, Board Member, CIMA Canada. Our members reside across Canada. Having presentations recorded is the only way to make them available to the entire membership. Furthermore, the ability to revisit presentations is especially important for our annual tax update events because each slide contains so much numeric information. Robert Thompson, Director of Sales, AV Canada. Recording and archiving events has time and time again proved to be a great value to our clients. Having access to conference content after doors close is a great access for any organization and increases ROI on the entire event. Elizabeth Bushler, PhD, President, InsideTech, Inc.
For me, as a regular conference attendee, recording presentations is an excellent idea. I like having information provided electronically. I want to be able to go back to review certain presentations. It allows academics to share conference material with their students. To me, this is a no-brainer.
Those conferences that record their events do so because they realize its value. The fact that delegates at SPECT or often demand it provides the added incentive. The reason why it is still not more universal is twofold. Number one, event organizers are afraid that it will interfere with the flow of the program. This is a myth. Tried and tested technologies make it simple and transparent. And number two, they are also concerned with cost. This is another myth. It can be clearly demonstrated that it has minimal effect on the overall budget while delivering important benefits. As Dr. Bushler said, it is a no-brainer.